Now the only salvation, the only refuge, the only redress will be yani te charitanisha manushyaah sadhava kalau shrinvantah kirtayantascha. Listen to the stories of the exploits and excellences of God, which God has done in different types of descent, so called avataras. Now take Srimad Bhagavatam itself. 18,000 Sanskrit verses are there. How many avataras it speaks about? On Krishna himself, the 10th skandha, there are 90 chapters there. All of them dealing with the birth, growth, excellences, exploits, adventures, glories, splendor, and achievements of Krishna. You can go on listening to Srinvantaha, Kirtayandasya. After some time, you will yourself start Kirtana, singing about the glories. So, listening to and also singing the glories. Srinvantaha, Kirtayandasya, Tarishyadi, Anjasatamaha. The influence, the stronghold of ignorance, Maya, nescience, we are all suffering from. We will be able to break the boundaries of tamas, ignorance, and we will be able to feel the necessary measure of freedom, ecstasy. The only way is for that. That is why we describe Srimad Bhagavatam to be swadu swadu pade pade, swadu swadu dine dine. Every day you start reading Bhagavatam, you will find it more and more delicious, delicious, sweet. Swadu swadu pade pade, word after word also it will be so. At the same time, for scholarly people who want to go into every word, meaning, purpose, etc., Vidyavatam Bhagavate Pariksha, it is also a constant examination, a question mark before the scholarly minds and intellects. Yanite charitanisha manushyah sadhava kalau shrinvantah kirtayandascha tarishyadi anjasatamaha. Without any difficulty and without waiting for long, the chanting of God's name, the singing of His glories, listening to the narration as Parikshit is doing in front of Shuka Maharshi. Parikshit is only listening. He does not perform anything at all, religious, spiritual, philosophical or yogic. Simply listens to. So by listening and singing, they will be able to easily cross over the quagmire of ignorance surrounding us. Yani te charitanisha manushyah sadhava kalau. This is particularly so in Kali Yuga. In Kali Yuga, we are not generally ascetic or austere in nature. We are very busy with the rat race world. Everybody is after gaining glories, material possessions. How many different branches of knowledge are offered now? Everyone wants to be an MBA these days. Ordinary graduation and masters will not be sufficient. We want MBA. That is the craze now. Everybody wants to join the IT field. What for? Because they will pay more. So our idea is completely different now. In Kali Yuga, we are after money, after wealth, after possessions, after externalities. People are extrovert, not introvert at all. So in Kali Yuga, manushyaha, sadhavaha, good and noble people, if you have to have a love or fondness for Srimad Bhagavatam, or listening to the narration of godly adventures, exploits, glories, etc., you must be a good person. Today, before coming to this Samadhi Mandir for speaking for our inner spiritual splendor, a young boy, a promising boy who has done MCA, he has come from Bombay, from Mumbai. He is already employed there. He said, Swamiji, this IT field is not for me at all. I don't want it. I want to get away from it. He's a very good boy, enterprising boy, very efficient, very sensible also. But he says, no, this is not my life. I find the people are behaving in a very strange manner. They want to be in their company, smoking, and the other addiction also, liquor. Unless I join them, they don't care for me. I cannot lose my life like this. I cannot get lost. So I want to keep away from it. No more Mumbai for me. No more Mumbai. Even if I am going to be paid only half my salary, I want to be somewhere here with my parents. You see, the world is like that. A young boy has this much to say. We all look for employment, look for decent positions. What for? To become corrupt? Can we not progress with virtue, with orderliness, with restraint, with regulation? Can a civilization be called civilized unless it has reformation and refinement associated with it? What is refinement? It is not gross. It is something subtle in nature. You must become a person of mind, a person of intelligence, a person of heart. Not that you become a person of the senses and the material world outside. We are human beings. Our delights will have to be inner. And everyone should be given to sensitiveness, refinement. We should live and move with insight, perception. In human life, the intelligence must be supreme. The delights of the mind and heart should be superior to the delights of the senses outside. So I think we have to redefine our civilization. Yanite charitanisha manushyaha sadhava kalau. So this is the nature, the rat race of Kali Yuga, in that whoever are noble, good, who want to be good, who want to mean to be good, such people, shrinvandaha kirtayandasya tarishyantyanjasatamaha, for them Srimad Bhagavata is a close associate. They will get a copy of Srimad Bhagavatam, start reciting it themselves. It will become part of the routine of the house. Buy a copy, start reading it. Initially you may not understand. Later on you will find you cannot spare it at all. You cannot be separated from it. As the Gopikas were unable to stand the separation from Krishna, you will not be able to stand separate from Srimad Bhagavatam. It will come to that state. Now Brahma says, Yadu vamshe avatirnasya bhavataha purushottama. Oh Purushottama, you have taken a human birth in the Yadu vamsha. Sharachatam vyadiyaya. Normally people are supposed to live for 120 years. And nobody generally lives up to that length. Sharachatam vyadiyaya panjavimshadhigyam vibho. You have lived all the 125 years. Normally, people live maximum allotted human span, lifespan is 120 years. Now, we don't generally wait for 120 years. Even when we people reach the age of 60, they say, everyone will start murmuring. 60 means only the middle age, and we are supposed to be quite agile and active with a good memory, with a good sensibility, etc. But this is not the case. In the case of Sri Krishna, it is said that Sharachatam Vidiyaya Panjavimshadhigyam Prabho. Not only the 120 years, the full human lifespan, you have already exceeded it by another 5 years. That means Krishna has already lived for 125 years. Yadu Vamshe Avatirnasya Bhavatah Purushottama Sharachatam Vidiyaya Panjavimshadhigyam Prabho. You have already completed the lifespan of 120 years, exceeded it also by another 5. What more is required, Krishna? If I don't come here and you are left to yourself, you may not return at all. But that is not the purpose. Nadhunate akhiladhara devakarya avasheshitam kulamcha viprasabena nashtaprayam abhudidam. Nadhunate akhiladhara. I would like to remind you, though a reminder is not called for, you are the supporter and the sustainer of all the universe and the universal beings. As many worlds as there are within the universe, you are the only sustainer. So it is not enough if you look after the welfare of the earthly denizens. There are people in the heavenly heights, there are so many places. So you are to look after all of them. You are the only substratum, only support. Akhiladhara. नाधुना ते देवकार्यावशेषितम्. यू हैव टेकन ह्यूमन बर्थ एट मई बिहेस्ट. आई केम एंड रिक्वेस्टेड टू यू सेइंग दैट द अर्थ इज नॉट एबल टू बेयर द लोड ऑफ विकेड पीपल, सो मेनी ऑफ दम. शी रिक्वायर्स अ रिलीफ. Therefore, please get born and dispense with the lives of so many wicked people who are proving excess load to the earth. That has been accomplished. So from our point of view, we can say, at our behest, you took the human birth and the whole mission is completed. There is nothing in the form of a remainder or a balance. Nadhunate akhiladhara devakaryavasheshitam kulam cha viprasapena nashtaprayam abhudidam. Not only yours, the whole of your clan, the entire vamsha, Vrishni vamsha, kulam cha viprasapena nashtaprayam abhudidam. Nashtaprayena abhudidam viprasapena. By virtue of the curse pronounced by the Brahmanas, your entire kula is almost gone. Nashtaprayam abhud. It is only a matter of days because the curse is so powerful. I am wondering whether I should tell you what the curse is. You know, for every incident, there must be some kind of a causal development. For the destruction of Krishna's clan also, there was a cause. Krishna invited all the prominent sages once to perform a particular ritual in Dwaraka, and all of them arrived there. And the sages were no less personalities than Vishwamitra Maharshi, Asita, Kanva, Durvasas, Bhrigu, Angiras, Kashyapa, Vamadeva, Atri, Vasishtha, Narada, and the rest. So it was a very, very respectable, austere assembly. All of them were stalwarts in spiritual life, asceticism and austerity. Now after the performance was over, they went back to a place. Krishna sent them to a place called Pindaraga. And they were camping there. Right at that time it so happened that some of the boys of the Dwaraka, the Yadu clan, they started playing. And suddenly, a flight of imagination, suddenly it occurred to them. So they took Samba, a youthful person amongst them, and dressed him like a girl with pregnant stomach, beautifully dressed. And they decided, let us go to these Maharshis. These Maharshis are spiritually exalted people. So whatever we ask them, they will be able to tell us. So they went there. With a lot of submission, after prostrating, they submitted before the sages. See, this girl is very bashful. She is very shy. She is pregnant. She wants to know, what child will she have, a boy or a girl? The Maharshis understood the fake nature of the whole episode. So they got irritated. You can play with anybody, but can you play with sages? Ascetic masters? Are they to be played with? Or you can beseech them, you can prostrate before them, seek instruction. What does Bhagavata say? When the Navayogis came, Nimichakravarti welcomed them, seated them, washed their feet, and asked them to expose Bhagavata Dharmas. Krishna says that his own predecessor, Yadu Chakravarti, when he met an Avadhuta, he did not speak in any light-hearted manner or sportful manner. He instantly got down from the chariot, prostrated before him, and asked him, what is the insight that makes you move about, ramble about in this manner? And there ensued a very huge conversation, a very lengthy conversation. Now, this is the attitude we must have towards all respectable people, particularly spiritually great men. On the other hand, what did these children do? Can you say it's all innocent? In innocence, innocent things can be done. But can it go to such a height that you dress a youthful man like a girl, a pregnant woman, and then you want somebody to tell you what child will be born? What is this? So they got very angry. They understood the fictitious nature of the whole episode. They said, she will give delivery to an iron pestle, they said. And literally it happened. She delivered an iron pestle. It's a he. Now, after having committed the mistake, all of them went to Ugrasena, and then bashfully they submitted. This is what has happened. Ugrasena did not inform anybody. Apparently even Krishna was not informed. He suddenly ordered. What did he order? He said that the pestle should be filed into fine powder, and when the whole thing is powdered, throw it into the sea in saline water. Nothing will sprout there. This is what was asked. They did so. After filing and filing and filing, you see, ultimately there will be a small portion, a tip. That tip cannot be filed. So when that was left, they threw that also into the sea. And it is said that this powdered pestle, by repeated roaring waves, all of them were brought to the seashore and they start growing there as a typical kind of grass. It has got a triangular stem. You can say it's a very flexible stick to some extent, you can say. And the entire Vishnu dynasty, they got into a quarrel, mutual quarrel, started beating each other with this particular grass and they died. That is what is going to happen. This is what Brahma is referring to. Avatiryayadorvamshe bibhradrupam anuttamam. And the last portion of the pestle, somehow a fish swallowed it. And that fish was caught hold of by a fisherman. When he opened it, he found this small portion, needle-like thing is there, made of iron. So he gave it to a hunter. And the hunter uses that to hit the foot of Krishna. So the whole curse, it devoured the entire dynasty. And Krishna also became a part of the curse. You see, this is how you find the human fulfillment and completeness of Krishna's life. Nadhunate akhila adhara devakarya avasheshitam kulam cha viprashapena nashtaprayam abhudidam. Now, I was explaining to you viprashapa, the shapa pronounced by the sages, by the vipras. Now, nashtaprayam abhudidam, already overpowered by, caught by the curse, pronounced by Vipras, the sages, your family is almost gone. Tadaswadhama paramam vishaswa yadimanyase salokan lokapalannaha pahi vaikunthakingaran. Tadaswadhama paramam vishaswa yadimanyase. My dear Lord Krishna, everything is over. Your whole mission is over. And the whole clan is going to be destroyed. The destructional wave has already started. So it is very timely that you also come back. Come back. Tataha swadhama paramam vishaswa. Mark the words used. Therefore, my dear Lord, paramam swadhama vishaswa yadi manyase. If you also agree to my request, please enter your own sovereign abode. Your own sovereign abode. Here you have come only 125 years back. But the universe has been existing for countless millions of years, trillions of years. So there are other areas also. Your right abode is high up in the celestial regions. There is Vaikuntha. There, Vishaswa, please re-enter. You have come away from there, vacated that seat at my request. Now my request has been fulfilled. I myself submit before you. So please, without caring for anything else, considering anything else, please come back. Yadi manyase, provided you feel my request is proper and it is in order for you to come back. I cannot, of course, intercept or force anything on you. But as I requested then to come down, I am fulfilling the other part of the mission. I have come down to request you to come up. Tadaswadhama paramam vishaswa yadi manyase salokan lokapalan naha pahi vaikunthakingaran. We are also a large team of people. Salokan lokapalan naha. We are all controllers of the different worlds. The universe consists of innumerable worlds. And all of them are ruled by one of us. One of us rules each of them. So many rulers are there. Salokan, lokapalan, naha. This earth is only a small mustard-like creation in the large committee of planets and heavenly bodies. So there, along with the worlds, the Lokapalas, the rulers of the world, Pahi Vaikuntha Kingaran. See, Brahma himself says, Naha Pahi Vaikuntha Kingaran. We are all obedient servants to Vaikuntha. We are at your behest, at your command. And if you leave us, you have already left us for a short term, 125 years. We are already feeling the impact. We are lordless. So please come back, take your seat, and be our master, our lord, our commander. Salokan Lokapalan Naha Pahi Vaikuntha Kingaran. Brahma himself says that, including me, all the Lokapalas are under you. We are only to serve you, please you, and fulfill your commands and behests. Krishna heard whatever Brahma submitted, and he responds to it. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Avadharitame Tanme Yadatha Vibhudeshwara Kritam Vaha Karyamakilam Bhumer Bharoho Vataridaha Tadidam Yadavagulam Virya Shaurya Shriyodhadam Lokam Jigrikshad Ruddham Me Velayeva Maharnavaha. See, I told you, Sarvaram Pahidoshena Dhumer Agniribhavrida. Every undertaking is associated with an evil. Krishna's descent was very important, and it was meant for ensuring the welfare of the earth. And see what has happened. Avadharitame tanme yadatha vibhudeshwara kritam vaha karyamakilam bhumer bharoho avadharitaha. My dear Brahma, whatever you have said, vibhudeshwara, you are very knowledgeable, and you are a lord of the knowers of truth. So whatever you have said, avadharitame tanme, I have understood it very well. I have accepted it also. Kritam vaha karyamakilam bhumer bharoho avataridaha. Whatever you wanted me to do in this world, akhilam karyam, all that mission has been fulfilled. Bhumer bharoho avataridaha. The excess load the bhumi, the earth, was suffering from in the hands of the wicked people, all of it I have removed. Avataridaha. No more wicked person is left now. Avadharitame tanme yadatha vibhudeshwara kritam vah karyamakhilam bhumer bharo avataridaha. So Krishna himself says that he has fulfilled the whole mission, however complex it was. But in the whole process, something undesirable has taken place. Tadidam yadavagulam virya shaurya shriyodhadam Lokam jigrikshad ruddham me velayeva maharnavaha. My dear viewers, are you listening with attention? What does Krishna say? Krishna, Krishna, the Supreme Almighty, come down in the form of a human to fulfill the timely need of the earth. So it is all something very holy and great. And he says, Tadidam Yadavakulam. In this dynasty, Yadavakula, where I have taken by birth, you know what has happened? For the first time in their history, I have brought fame, recognition, prestige, pomp, power, glory, splendor, everything I have brought on them. And they have been assisting me in fighting all the wars, in bringing about order, in destroying the wicked people. There were stalwarts like Bhishma, Drona, Kripa, so many others. Jarasandha was there, Shishupala was there, Narakasura was there. All of them were encountered by me. And all these people have assisted me for that. Having assisted me and having won such a great mission, having fulfilled it, you know what has happened in the process? In the process, virya, shaurya, shriyodhadam. They have become extremely proud, uncontrollably conceited. By virya, valor, shaurya, heroism, shriya, prosperity. They were cowherd people. Now it is not so. They have huge coffers filled with jewels, gold and what not. So much is there. So otherwise they were austere people, poor people. Now they excel the royal members and the royal families and palaces. So Virya Shaurya Shriyodhadam, they have become blind. Blind with the pride, pride of valor, pride of heroism, pride of adventurism, pride of prosperity. And as a result, what are they thinking? Logam jigrikshadu. They want to destroy the entire world to prove their dominance and superiority. Ruddham me velayeva maharnavaha. You know, the whole clan is almost like a sea. Just like the sea is restrained by the shore, I act as a shore. I keep them in check. Don't overflow. Don't overflow. Remain within the shores. You have so much of water. You know, the earth, three quarters are filled with the sea. Only one quarter is the land. So you can...